The Assembly will now hear a statement by Her Excellency Kamla Persad-Bissessar, Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago.
Thank you very much, Madam President, Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen all. Trinidad and Tobago is honored to participate in this very special session of the United Nations on the International Conference on Population and Development. We take this opportunity to acknowledge with appreciation the report of the Secretary General entitled Framework of Actions for the Follow-up to the Program of Action of the International Conference on Population and Development Beyond 2014, as well as the Index Report on the Interactive Debate of the 47th Session of the Commission on Population and Development. As Prime Minister, I have the honor and privilege to report that Trinidad and Tobago has contributed to the Global Survey for the ICPD Beyond 2014 review, and wish to emphasize that Trinidad and Tobago has made considerable progress in implementing the Program of Action of the International Conference on Population and Development. President, kindly allow me a moment to enumerate some of the areas in which my government has implemented the Program of Action of the ICPD for the benefit of our citizens. And before I do so, let me reiterate that my government has placed emphasis on people-centered development. And so when we look at population and development, we are looking at people development, people-centered development, and basically looking at human development. We see our philosophy has been not just on the concrete and steel and on the buildings, but it must be in the human resource, in the human development. And so we have placed emphasis in the areas of education, employment, health, and the provision of several social safety nets for the poor through the Minister of the People and Social Development. It should be noted that a significant portion of our budgetary resources allocated for our upcoming financial year have been dedicated to education, as well as programs which target women, especially single mothers. Once more, education has received a lion's share of the national budget as we seek to make our education system MDG plus, which will result in Trinidad and Tobago achieving universal early childhood education by 2015. We have already achieved universal primary education and universal secondary education, so that we have education right up to the tertiary sector, which is free education in our country. I have recently redesigned certain programs in the Ministry with responsibility for youth affairs, with a view to ensuring that young people, especially the vulnerable, benefit through avenues available in the education system, as well as from skills, training, mentoring, and youth help programs. Most recently, in addressing issues of the poor, my government introduced a new program to provide financial assistance for any child born to underprivileged parents. The government of Trinidad and Tobago has achieved a number of successes with regard to implementing the program of action of the ICPD. However, we are quite aware that there remain certain challenges, but we are committed to ensuring equality and equity in an environment which would harness the talents of current and future generations. Notwithstanding the strides we have made through proactive intervention by government, including efforts to improve the efficacy of our CSO, Central Statistical Office, in order to promote evidence-based policymaking, we recognize that there is still need for assistance from our development partners to strengthen our institutional capacity in some areas, including data collection and statistical systems. This would enable us to implement more effectively government policies. special sessions such as these are therefore important, so that member states have the opportunity to share with each other best practices and other experiences. Additionally, a national population policy is in the process of being finalized and will further facilitate the level of data analysis to address key population issues. We have already begun to put measures in place to ensure that Trinidad and Tobago is not left behind with regard to the implementation of a transformative post-2015 development agenda. In this regard, programs are being developed by relevant national agencies to address issues relating to prenatal and neonatal care, as well as other issues affecting the health of mothers and infants. Trinidad and Tobago notes with satisfaction the emphasis placed in the Secretary General's report on issues related to human rights, and we fully support the conclusion of the report that investing in individual human rights, capabilities, and dignity across the multiple sectors of the ICPD and throughout the life course is the foundation of sustainable development. We also advocate that sustainable development requires a holistic approach and recognition of the interlinkages between human rights and the population dynamics that have materialized and which continue to emerge. As I close, President, I say increasingly diverse household structures and living arrangements require us to plan and build sustainable cities and strengthen urban-rural linkages. It is therefore crucial that we understand the population dynamics at the micro and macro levels for seamless integration into development planning at the national, regional, and international levels. We agree that the development challenges we face require systematic participation of all stakeholders in crafting responses to these challenges, which require partnership and global leadership through the United Nations. And so my country is very proud to join the international community in reaffirming support for the historic ICPD program of action, as well as for the transformational vision presented in the report of the Secretary General. I thank you very much.
I thank Her Excellency the Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago for her statement.